So Apple is bringing a very popular feature from the iPhone to the Mac in its upcoming macOS Monterey software update, and that feature is low power mode. Apple says it manages energy intensive apps and processing to increase battery life and to make your Mac run quieter. So, with the MacBook Air already pulling in excellent battery life, I decided to install it on my M1 to see how much longer it lasts. Hey everyone, I'm Spot, and this is the macOS Monterey low power mode battery test. Alright, the MacBook is fully charged, so let's begin the test. We will have two clips side by side with low power mode disabled on the left, which I will call standard power mode, and low power mode enabled on the right. In this test, we're going to be simulating some continuous moderate usage with 2.5 hours of typing and auto-saving to the cloud in Microsoft Word, 4 hours of YouTube and Google Chrome, 2 in full screen and 2 in default view, 1.5 hours of FaceTime video, and finishing off the test with streaming music and Spotify until they both run out of charge. Display and keyboard brightness is set to 65%, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are switched on, and I have a few apps open in the background like email, notes, and messages. So quickly making our way through the first test, we can see that after 2.5 hours of typing in Microsoft Word, low power mode has an advantage of 3%, draining 14% compared to 17% in standard power mode. It doesn't seem like much of a difference at the moment, but typing a word isn't the most intensive task, so we shall see what happens when we stream YouTube videos in Google Chrome. So here we're just watching a playlist of random YouTube videos with the volume set to 35%, and after 2 hours into this test, we will be switching it to default view. So we are almost 30 minutes into this test, and it looks like standard power mode is at 78%, while low power mode is at 82%, so the difference has increased to 4% between these two modes. Speeding up the time lapse and approaching 2 hours of streaming YouTube videos in full screen, the difference has increased to around 6%. As the test continues, we can actually see that it is starting to get dark outside, which just shows the impressive battery life on these notebooks. Anyway, we have 55% left on standard power mode and 61% left in low power mode. Getting close to 5 hours since we started this battery test, we can see that both laptops are still going strong with more than 50% of its battery left. Getting darker and darker on the left, we are almost 6 hours into this test, and at the moment we have around 20 minutes left until we complete the total of 4 hours of streaming YouTube videos in Google Chrome. So reaching 6 hours and 30 minutes, we can actually see that the difference has further increased to 11%, which is actually quite significant for an M1. Anyway, now we're moving on to the FaceTime test with 29% left in standard power mode and 40% left in low power mode. FaceTime is actually quite a power intensive task, as it's pretty much a constant stream of audio and video to and from the person you're on a video call with. A little more than an hour into this test, we can see that standard power mode has dropped down to 15%, and reaching a total of 8 hours into this test, we can actually see that standard power mode has only drained 3% more, but the differences have added up and have left it with only 10% remaining, being first to show its low battery notification. Ending the FaceTime call and opening up Spotify, we're going to finish off this test by streaming music until they both completely run out of charge. So we have started streaming music in Spotify, which is playing the Daily Mix playlist here. It looks like standard power mode has dropped down to 7% within a few minutes. Speeding up this time lapse and moving to 8 hours and 40 minutes, standard power mode drops to its last 1%, and at exactly 8 hours and 56 minutes and 25 seconds, standard power mode calls it a day and finishes off the test right there. Passing the 9 hour mark here, we still haven't got any low battery notifications yet from the MacBook in low power mode, but finally, half an hour later, at 9 hours and 32 minutes, we get the 10% low battery notification. Moving along, the MacBook Air in low power mode is still taking its time with 7% left after 10 hours of continuous usage. Currently passing 10 hours and 7 minutes, we have 6% left, and finally, as we speed up this video at 10 hours and 40 minutes, the MacBook drops to its last 1%, and after another 6 minutes it finally decided to call it a day and went to sleep after a whopping 10 hours and 46 minutes. So, from this test, low power mode was able to get an extra 1 hour and 50 minutes of continuous usage. So if you're wondering whether to turn on this feature or not, yes, I would highly recommend turning on low power mode on battery, but you can also choose to turn it on when plugged in, so your laptop can run quieter and cooler as well. This would be perfect for Intel Mac users, but do keep in mind that your CPU performance will drop if you turn on low power mode. Anyway, that's pretty much it for this low power mode battery test. If y'all enjoyed this video, please drop a like and consider subscribing for more videos like this. macOS Monterey is coming out soon, so if you do have any thoughts, I'd love to hear them in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers, bye.